heard some weird, wild stuff. That is funny. I did not know that.
Dropping drawers and stabbing whores on the Kevin Holly Show.
And I gotta say, he has balls. This man has balls. He's laying them out there for us to see.
That really sounds like our first date kit.
Ever shared a lustful evening with a Muslim woman?
We're dropping drawers and stabbing whores. It's the Kevin Holly Show.
Anyone who can turn a dial.
I've got a pirate radio station. Nobody knows who he is.
You out there? You listening?
A moment of silence. Welcome to the Kevin Holly Show. It is episode 32. We're looking at April 6th, 1776, my man. What's going on? Jay Bird in the house.
I can't believe it. I turned 32 this month.
You turned 32 this month. Wow, yeah. Dude. You're getting old, man. Hey, we got Pops in the house as well. Pops, what's going on, my friend?
What?
How's Pops doing tonight?
I'm here.
He's here. All right. Don't
glad
get
you're not hosting the first hour of the show tonight, man.
Who am I?
What the hell, man? Well, Pops is not happy tonight. Well, I don't understand. Oh.
What's going on, Dad?
Just facing reality.
And what is that?
But I'll just look out what I see, and it's not a pretty picture.
Are you talking about the guys in the studio or the window view?
What?
Are you talking about the view outside, or are you talking about looking at Camden sitting across from you?
Well, wherever you go, looking outside at the deeper thing and then looking here in this room.
I think the spirits got him down, man.
I think the spirits got him down.
Yeah. It's something to do with the building, bro. You can't
just... I'm totally depressed. Yeah.
Well, we're going to pick you up tonight, Pops. Don't you worry about it, man.
Yeah.
We're going to totally take care of
you
tonight.
I'm not going to worry about anything.
And if not, we'll
ever again.
You know, a couple things I want to say. First off, he's not looking at Camden. He's looking at Mudcat.
That's right. We've got a special sitting guest tonight for Homeless Chuck, who is out sick once again. I wouldn't say he's sick, but he hurt his back or something. I don't know if he was curled up wrong in the fetal position of his dumpster, but Chuck called out. So we have somebody in his place here. That would be, Camden's new nickname, Mudfish? What the hell is that, dude?
Dude, it's what I was given. You can't choose a name.
Who gave it to you?
I did.
Yeah.
I gave it to him. He's got Mudcat on the side of his arm right there, dude. Actually, here's where the story goes. We were all sitting on the back, and we were trying to figure out a name for, you know, one Mr. Pugh, and we all said Catfish, like, at the same time. And, you know, there's a Catfish that's like a DJ on a radio station in Florida. So I didn't want to, like, mimic it or be something like that.
He's not the Catfish. Can't be. There's already a Catfish.
Yeah, but he's a true Catfish because
look at the whiskers
on his face. He's got a tattooed on his arm.
Oh, so if I had a Tasmanian devil, would I be Taz?
So Cam was like, what about Mudcat?
Mudcat.
Mudcat.
He does sound. He sounds like he's awesome. He sounds like he's in the weeds, like a mud duck or a mudcat. And he's all quiet in the corner, sweaty, barefoot. What the hell, bro? You don't have shoes?
Yeah, it's a casual Wednesday.
No, casual is like shorts and a t-shirt or jeans day or something. Barefoot and half nude. I mean,
half nude?
Yeah, you got a tank top and overalls.
I'm wearing probably more clothing than you are right now, Kevin.
I hope so, but dude.
Mudcat, tell him when he gets the air conditioning paid for here in the office during the podcast, you'll wear shoes.
Yeah.
Make that deal with him.
Whenever
at least he's not stinky.
Gets paid for around this thing.
Well, you know.
You know?
You can contribute if you want, bro.
You should be paying me.
Yeah, well, whatever, dude. As long as your feet don't stink, I guess I don't really care. You know, whatever's on the floor will probably stick to your feet, and you'll take it with you. So it's kind of like you're cleaning the place up for us, which I appreciate, bro.
Yeah,
I should
this place
be paying
is
you.
Disgusting.
It's not. What are you doing, Jay? You texting people?
Actually, I'd like to start the show off with this right away because it's on my mind. And
what are you doing?
We went to McDonald's before we came to the podcast, and they did not fulfill our order to their full potential. So,
what do you mean?
Bear with me for a little bit.
Is this about the apple pies?
Yeah. Yeah.
You're going to do this live on the air?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh man, shut the door real quick. Oh God, here we go. All right, really? Really doing this?
Yeah. Camden didn't get his sweet and sour sauce either.
No, he did. He stepped on it and made a mess on the floor. But luckily, yeah, I saw it, dude. It's still in the wastebasket.
It was not sweet and sour sauce.
It totally is, dude. It's in the basket.
It was not.
It's in the basket.
It was not in there.
Put the sauce in the basket.
Kevin, if you peek one more time, I'm going to smack you across the head, dude.
If I peek one more time?
Yeah, dude, you keep peeking all over.
That's my show. I can peek all I want. I can barely hear you, mudfish.
Barely
hear you. There
you
go. Yeah.
Well, every time I do this, then it gets red on me.
You would think a professional musician such as yourself would know to put his face up to the microphone.
I'm a professional acoustic musician.
Okay.
Yes.
So you're not used to being plugged
evidently,
in.
They care about their service. Like,
Did you disguise the number? Or?
No, I don't care.
Okay.
This is a true call, man. I don't have to disguise nothing. I'm not going to tell them.
I don't think they're going to answer, dude.
Why?
Because they don't care about you or your apple pies, man. Or your sweet and sour sauce. Your duck sauce, your mudfish sauce.
Call them here in a little bit. We'll give them another call here in a little bit.
What if there was a such thing as mudfish sauce? What would that taste like, Camden?
Mudfish is a thing.
It is a thing.
And mudfish sauce is also a thing.
Cool. Hey, just let that ring all night, man. It's cool. We can wait.
All right, I see. All right, so let's get on to what we have later in the hour, isn't? Something with Andrew Dice Clay later.
Talking about catfish. I don't know if I ever told you, Jay. I think I told Tyler, but when I was a kid, we had a pond down at the end of the road. And one year it was, or for a couple of years, it was so dry that we had catfish in that pond. They were 2 years old, hadn't learned how to swim yet.
How do you know how old they were?
I remember when they first came, and 2 years later, they weren't still swimming.
You remember when they first came? Wait a minute.
This is taking a turn for the worse, man.
Grow up.
All right, so, ladies and gentlemen.
Turn for the worse, yeah.
Welcome once again to the Kevin Holly Show. We do have a hotline that is wide open tonight, so if you want to call in, 727-237-6010. We also have a Twitter account that we will monitor throughout the show. It's at Kevin Holly Show 4. We've got a lot in store.
Why is there
a 4? Because Kevin Holly Show without a number was taken. There's some imposters out there.
Wait, really?
Yeah.
Kevin Holly Show 1 through 3 was taken?
I believe they were taken.
Really?
I believe so.
That's exactly what I said the first time I heard that, Cam.
Yeah,
I was like,
well, there's
mean,
four
really?
Of us. Jay, yeah, why are you freaking out, Jay? Is it really about McDonald's?
Yeah, I
you want
so
your pie?
Want to do this, dude. I so want to do this. I'm telling you, I'm calling
you're,
another
you
number.
You are freaking out a little bit.
Call the corporate office, man.
Yeah, just call the corporate office, dude.
All right, so tonight during the show, we've got a lot lined up. We've got a bit of a discussion about Rick Scott. We're going to talk about Rick Scott, the governor of Florida. We're going to talk a little bit about Chuck, homeless Chuck, who's not here. Jay's got some weird idea for kids. I don't know what that's all about, but I do remember when he had his own van. So we'll see what that's about. Pops has a couple things he's brought to the table. About the moon, the lottery. We've got discussions about the Chasco Pasco Fiasco Festival.
Hello?
Uh-oh. Oh, here we go.
I was just there a little bit ago, and I just want to make a complaint.
Uh-oh.
Are you a manager?
Yes.
right. I came through and I ordered like two value meals, cheeseburger, fries with Cokes, and then I ordered 20 chicken nuggets, and I wanted barbecue sauce, and I also wanted sweet and sour sauce.
Sweet and sour.
And we got Cokes with our value meals, and then I ordered two
apple pies. Yeah.
Apple pies. But our pies, value meals had Cokes on it, and we got our Cokes, but we didn't get our two apple pies, and we didn't get sweet and sour sauce with our chicken nuggets.
That's right. And no apple pies.
Did you want to come back and get a replacement or anything? No, I live in Hudson, man. I'm pretty far away to drive for two apple pies.
Lies.
And sour sauce.
Lies.
I guess I just want to ask. I mean, you know, it pisses me off.
You're a dick if you call McDonald's and tell them you're pissed off. Yeah, do that.
All right, so
tell them your name is Homeless Chuck.
What do I do? Just walk in and be like, listen, you guys owe me fries. You don't owe me fries. You owe me... But here's the thing is, like, you owe me sweet and sour sauce.
And pies.
So unless
and
I order more
pies,
nuggets...
he said.
All right, so pies. If I just walk in and say, you guys owe me free pies, you're going to give me pie?
Hair pie. And they're going to spit in it.
All right.
Glick, that's Pops' air hoses.
How about
air
you guys
hoses.
Bring them up? You got anybody around that can bring them to me in Hudson?
Not really.
Not really. What does that mean?
Well, not really or maybe. I mean...
Just tell them Homeless Chuck's going to come pick up the stuff.
You don't understand. This is
killing me, dude.
This is killing me because...
No, this is killing me, dude.
No, this is killing me.
I'm turning your mic off, dude. Just tell him Homeless Chuck is your name.
Listen, put my name down in the books. I'll be back for my apple pies. Homeless Chuck. What's your name?
My name's Eric.
Eric?
Yeah.
All right, Eric. All
right.
Thanks. Have a good night.
Terrible. Don't forget Homeless Chuck.
Places ran like shit.
All right, so thank you.
Sorry, I had to do that.
We'll never have McDonald's sponsor our show. Thanks, bro. Yeah, but who needs them anyway, man?
Yeah.
All right, so what else do we have tonight? Cultural appropriation. We're going to talk about that for real?
Yeah. Okay. Well, we're going to talk about why it's absurd.
Okay, and the Panama Papers. That's Camden's brought a lot to the table as well, and he's a guest. That's pretty badass, man. All right, and most importantly, we do have a special guest calling in again tonight, and it's another comedian, and you may have heard of him. He's very, very famous from the 80s, movies such as, what was that really awesome movie that he was in, Ford Fairlane, and from the Dice Men comedy stand-up from HBO. You've seen him all over TV. Andrew Dice Clay will be calling in the show tonight for a quick interview. I'm a little nervous because I didn't actually get to talk to him face to face. We only talked through social media.